Hey guys, welcome back to the HO Scale, Virginia Midland. Alright, video blog, video series, whatever you want to call it. I don't know what I'm going to call it. I know it's been a long time. Oh yes, it's been a long time, probably a couple months. You guys probably know. Been chomping at the bit. I know. Apologize. September, October have been really busy. A couple weeks, I was coaching Little League Baseball. Holy smokes, 2 weeks in there. Thinking in October was like something every day, so I apologize that. November's been a little bit better. Been getting some modeling done. Been doing some work for a customer of mine, Greg. I know you're probably watching. Couple other things. Laid some floor in here in the layout room. Put some laminate floor down. Was it last week? Yeah, last week. Started on it last Sunday. Finished probably most of the week after I went to work when I got home and got it done. Not too bad, just painstaking on your knees, just getting up and down with my tail a little bit, but it's not as bad. We did the same flooring or different color flooring in our family room. That was an adventure. Luckily, my wife helped me a lot, immensely in that. She didn't help me out in here. I had one of my oldest son help me out. I had to pay him about $20, but without his help, I'd probably still be doing it, so that's a good thing. So, let's get back to the layout here. What do I hope to accomplish here in the holidays coming up and things like that? Nothing major set in stone right now. Main thing, I've got one little track change down here at St. Just down on the lower level. I'm going to make the spur there, or the runaround track at St. Just a little bit longer. Going to get rid of a curve turnout. I don't think you guys can see it down here, but I've got a few curved turnouts on the layout. They're not probably the best idea to have, but when you're really don't have a whole lot of space, you almost have to use them. I try not to put them on the main line. Some of them are kind of tight, and the track work's got to be precise. Cars got to run well too, for them to work efficiently. So if you're looking at curved turnouts, the bigger probably the better. The smaller ones, the sharper diameter or radius, I should say, can be a little bit tougher. So get the ones in the middle or the bigger ones if you got room for them. But they help you out on small layout. I try to only have any in the yards or anything, but I do have a few on the layout. I probably have more than I thought I did. But anyways, that's probably my main thing. Probably going to knock that out this weekend. That isn't my plan. I'm still trying to get a little organized in here. Got all my stuff back in here. When I'm going to take everything out of here, putting the new floor in. And I'll show y'all a picture of that here in a second. A lot easier to do the floor. You don't have anything in here. The floor, though, you don't have a layout. The legs, I've got a few legs in here where the layout, hold the support, the layout. Those were not terrible. You use a jack, jacked it up, got it underneath it. With the laminate floor, you got to kind of put it in an angle and bend it and get it to lay flat. So nothing too hard. Nothing, I wouldn't say scale 0 to 10. Not the hardest thing. I'd say maybe a 4. Nothing terrible. It helps to have experience. If it was my first time laying in here, probably would have been fun. So, floor is like a P in here, so it's shaped like a P. So, not pretty square. If I had to do my kitchen, oh no. That's why I paid somebody to do that. So, getting back to the layout, anything else? I got a lot of scenery. I know you've seen my new building down here, my sweetener's place. Got to get some scenery in here. I'm going to rework my control panel. Get rid of a few things, move to some toggles and stuff. I got a bunch of toggles on a website. I want to put those in to make it look a little bit more up to date. Gonna need to get some car cards done. I want to do some opceptions just to get it, use these cards and get away from my checklist, or actually my switch list, I should say. But besides that, not a whole lot going on in here. I did weather some cars up. You can see those on my blog. Got a new locomotive that I think I'm going to do more, another six axle based off an SD35. It's going to probably be an SD, 30 something. It's not going to be a 39 or a 38. It might be like a, It's a layout. I'll show you what I mean. What I mean by that. But I really like my SD20-2, which is based off an SD35 chassis. Runs really well, six axle unit, and it's got that small. It's a short locomotive. That's what I like. It's a little bit longer than like a Jeep 40 or Jeep 38. So I really enjoy that. I'm going to do another one. Might have a new logo coming. We will see on that. I'll just leave it at that. Might have a new logo coming for the Virginia Midland. I know everybody enjoys my Virginia Midland, the updated one that I have, but might be going beyond that. But we'll see. I'll tell you about that later. Maybe in another video or on my blog. So, besides that, let's get to show you what I'm going to do on the trackage at St. Just and a few other things, show you my floor, and hopefully this will be a shorter video. Hopefully keep it right around 10 minutes or less. So I'll see you guys here in a bit. All right, welcome back. I've actually jumped right into this lower level extension here. Not really an extension, maybe just widen the shelf right here. As you can see, I had to add some bracket, or I wouldn't say brackets, but some about a 3-inch extension here, because where the hole is here that goes up to the helix, wanted to somehow camouflage that or hide that. So only way I could possibly do that would be adding in a 3-inch section in here, maybe putting some trees in this area right here, and maybe a little tiny bluff or something like there, so I have trees there to hide that hole, so when you look at it, doesn't appear as unrealistic as possible. I'm also going to put something inside of the wall there to maybe have trees and stuff on it to kind of better camouflage it. Almost like a tunnel. It's not really a tunnel, but a tunnel, kind of an interior inside the wall there to kind of camouflage it even better. I had to move, as you can see. It's a little bit of work, more work than I thought it was. It started over the weekend, but I got kind of lazy. But you know how that is sometimes. I've got this track already laid here. This is the main line coming out of the helix there, over in the backside there. I know it's hard to see. But the other track, this is the actual branch line here that goes down to Mine Run. And I had a curve turnout about right here. So I took that out, replaced it with a regular number 6 turnout there. So it gives me a little bit more room for my sand cars. I'd like to at least run 7 to probably 8 of them up and up to the upper level and then down to the lower level here to make it a little bit more, make my trains a little bit longer. The cars are short, they're 37 footers, so it does help out. So that's probably the longer train I run on the layout. I'm going to get ready to, I've got my hot glue gun getting ready to warm it up right now, so I'm going to glue that down there. I'm going to put some fascia up in here to kind of blend it all in there. As you can see, I've got my little the St. Just interlocking, because this is St. Just, and as you can see right over here to the left there, I got all my work tools and stuff. But there's Chesapeake Valley Sweeteners. CVS is over there. That's the project I did this summer right at the end. And the branch line goes off. Goes over to Mine Run. There's a propane dealership right there. Got some test cars there. As you can see, and it goes over to the branch of it. That's directly under Battlefield Yard. And that branch line's got a bunch of stuff on it right now, as you can see. My room is kind of in disarray here. I had to move my desk, because right here is where my main work desk is. To get there, I had to move it, so it slides nice on my new floor here. But hopefully I can finish this today, get the nice day. I think it's going to be in the upper 50, so I'll be able to paint the fascia and get this on. I had to move a tortoise machine right here, as you can see down here, from my curved turnout that was up here. So move that's not bad. I do have another turnout. Let me see if I can zoom a little bit here. I do have another turnout here that has no control. So if I put the trees and stuff there, that's going to add an interesting. And I'm thinking about, all right, I'll put another tortoise underneath it there. But A bracket is like exactly underneath of the points here. So I was like, So I'll figure something out. I might use a Caboose Hobbies, Caboose Throws. I'm not a big fan of those. A lot of people use them, very unrealistic. But I might just put something here. I have a gap where I can reach through and get it. So you know, just about done here. Really, the extension is weird. It's got to make a three extra inches here, and really no trackage. I do have to have a little bit of extra trackage. This is my runaround track. I have not ran the track yet for that. But I have some feeder wires, and I'll be in business. So that's enough of this project here. One other thing I want to show you here, and I will show you here just in a second.